everyone, and welcome to our 52nd annual Festival of Lights Christmas Parade in downtown Douglas, Georgia. And I'm Georgia Henderson, the City of Douglas Public Information Director, and along with me tonight is...
Terrell Jacobs, City Manager of the City of Douglas.
And I'm Stanley Lott. I'm with the Georgia Department of Labor Business Services Unit and also on the Board of Directors for the Douglas Coffee County Chamber of Commerce.
And we just want to wish everybody a Merry Christmas. Let me go ahead and get that out of the way before I forget it, for the night is over. And thank y'all for looking in at our annual Festival of Lights Christmas Parade. I think we have quite a bit of entries tonight. 75 entries, so well represented here through all the different community businesses and churches and things that are like. So I think George is going to share some other things with you. The CSX, we don't think December the 17th, next week. It'll start airing at 6 o'clock.
Today's the 5th.
It'll be Monday. Okay. Correction on all that. December the 7th. I thought we were beyond that. My bad.
You still thinking about 50 cents.
I haven't had anything to drink, and I promise you. But December the 7th, when this will be aired at 6 p.m., so please give a chance to watch it then. Winners for the parade will be contacted Monday afternoon. Winners will also be listed on the WDTV 13 through our local media sources as well. So
we'll recognize them at our next, The last commission meeting
is December the 28th. We'll recognize them at that time. So got a lot going on. Please view what you see on DCG 13, and hopefully this will be a great opportunity for you.
All right, so let's get ready to have a parade. We're going to take a break, and whenever we come back, we're going to hear from Patty Merritt, who is our Main Street Manager, and she's going to introduce our judges for this 52nd annual Christmas parade.
WDTV 13. Programming is sponsored by Harper & Company Builders, serving Douglas and Coffee County for 29 years. And a proud sponsor of community programming. Storage Solutions, etc., locally owned and operated and located at 1010 Bowens Mill Road, Southeast in Douglas.
American Truck Parts Incorporated, a proud sponsor of WDTV 13 programming.
Vickers Audio and Glass Tinting, supporting our local programming on WDTV 13.
Aiden's Minute Market. When you're out, we're in.
McCrary Daniels Insurance Agency.
Fletcher Oil Company, since 1966, has been supporting local activities and a proud sponsor of community programming on WDTV 13. Fletcher Oil Company is a member of the Women's Business Enterprise National Council.
Dewey Hayes Jr., attorney at law, selected to the top 100 trial lawyers in the state of Georgia.
Earn your degree for less at South Georgia State College. At SGSC, we offer associate degree programs as well as Bachelor of Science in Biological Sciences and a Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Both bachelor degrees are offered at the associate level tuition rate, and many financial aid options are available. Plus, classes are taught by credentialed professors who care about your success. Visit sgsc.edu to find out more and to set up your personal tour. South Georgia State College. You matter here.
You're not who you used to be, and neither are we. With a caring staff, experienced doctors, and the most advanced technology, Coffey Regional Medical Center in Douglas, Georgia is better than ever before.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to downtown Douglas for the 52nd annual
Festival of Lights Christmas Parade. As most of you are aware, each year we do have a select judges that are here in town, and the parade is judged, the floats, that is. Numerous churches, clubs, and organizations do enter the parade each year. So we try to get a variety of judges to come here to Douglas to judge our parade for us. So at this time, and I do apologize, I didn't introduce myself. I kind of think everybody probably should know me, but if you don't, I'm Patty Merritt, Main Street Manager for the City of Douglas. So we're going to go right on ahead, and I'm going to introduce to you, I'm getting a shout out. Do you guys hear this? I'm so popular. It's the City Manager. Anyway, thank you, Mr. Jacobs. I do appreciate it. Anyway, we're going to start here with our first judge. She is out of town, and I'm going to let her introduce herself and tell a little bit about herself.
Hey there, my name is Jana Dyke, and I'm with the City of Sylvester. I, too, am the Main Street Director and Downtown Development Authority Director for the City of Sylvester, and I just want to thank the City of Douglas for inviting me out tonight.
Thank you, Jana.
Hey, I'm Mackenzie Bennett, and I'm originally from Adel, Georgia, and I work with the Chamber of Commerce.
Chris Knight. I'm Cobb County Solid Waste Director. I'm here on behalf of the Cobb County Commissioners. We'd like to wish everyone a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Thank you, Chris, Mackenzie, and Jana. I do appreciate it. Ladies and gentlemen, just one quick reminder before I hand the mic over. This is the holiday season, and we just want to remind everyone to shop small, shop local. Your tax dollars do make a difference. Spending in downtown Douglas does make a difference, and we just encourage you to come downtown, stay local with us, shop during this holiday season. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year from the City of Douglas Main Street Division.
How's everybody doing?
Hello!
Okay. Trying to get y'all in the mood. How y'all enjoying this weather?
Is it cool enough for you?
Yeah.
Perfect parade weather. So glad to see all of you out tonight. How many have been coming to the parade for 10 years or more?
Raise your hand. Oh, wow.
Yeah, look up there.
How many? 20 years. 20. Okay, all y'all old folk. Okay.
Okay. Those of you been coming 20 years, come by the Douglas Visitor Information Center, see Kimberly, and she will give you. There's Kimberly going out there, Miss
KT.
Kimberly.
KT in the house.
Got to give Kimberly a shout out now.
And she has a gift for you for visiting our Douglas Visitor Information Center located at 211 South Gaskin Avenue in the beautiful Ashley Slater House. For real, that's true.
That's right. That's
we'll
right.
Give you a prize.
So we'll give you a prize, but now you got to tell the truth about you seeing this for 20 more years now, okay? Because if not telling the truth, the Grinch going to get you.
Get some cold.
That's right. He's going to give you a cold for your present for Christmas. That's right. Okay.
It won't be long before the parade starts. Whenever you see the police car and the sheriff department car, they officially lead off the parade. We'll have some antique cars and motorcycles and a parade marshal, and we'll begin from there.
Amen.
For those of you who do not know, this makes the 52nd annual Festival of Lights Christmas Parade.
Woo, woo, woo!
Come on, Coffee County, let's cheer that up.
Man, let's give a round of applause. All right. And for the crowd here gathered up, my name is Daryl Jacobs, City Manager, and this young lady here.
I'm Georgia Henderson. I'm the Public Information Director for the City of Douglas, and
we have our special guest. Let us rise, please.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Daryl Jacobs. I'm Stanley Lawton with the Georgia Department of Labor and Business Services Unit, and also on the Board of Directors for the Chamber of Commerce, Board of Directors for the Boys and Girls Club of the Cobb County Region, and I help do the football broadcast on Shine 1019 for the Cobb County Drug and Football.
He is the Shine 109 man, I'm telling you. All right. Well, we appreciate Stanley coming on board, helping us with these announcements. I believe we have 75 entries in the parade, so we got a lot to look at and a lot to hopefully take some perspective of. I believe the theme this year is what?
Santa's Workshop.
Santa's Workshop. So hopefully we'll see some themes of that nature. And I believe the police car is getting ready to go, so I got to do my little shout-out thing.
Go back.
Okay. I usually do this once a year. So
y'all please help him out.
Help me, because, you know, I'm originally challenged. I don't have any rhythm. I
are
know.
You ready for this, Stanley?
Y'all
you
say
ready?
A black man that doesn't have rhythm. There are a few of us.
You better get it going, because we see the lights coming.
When I say Merry, you say Christmas. Merry.
Christmas.
Merry.
Christmas.
When I say Merry, you say Christmas. Merry.
Christmas.
Merry.
Christmas.
All right, we're going to set
up. With you this year.
I did it good.
Give yourselves a hand.
That was Carol Jacobs.
All right, we see the flashing lights.
All right.
And Terrell, we don't have to worry about our football teams being in the SEC championship because both of them out of it. So we should be fully focused on this parade tonight.
That is true. Well, you know, Stanley, we're going to have a contrast issue here. I'm a Florida State fan.
Yeah, I know. They're not in the SEC championship.
Look what I'm in between up here. Would you look at this?
Neither one of them is in the running, right? No. So it won't make any difference. One of the things we might do a little different this time, let's get everybody to count down. And we're going to count down from 10. 10, 9, 8,
7,
6,
5,
4,
3,
2,
1.
All right, we start the parade. Good job. I believe that's our police chief, Gary Castellos, in the front car. Yep.
Merry Christmas, right. Chief Castellos.
And that's our sheriff, Mr. Wooten.
Merry Christmas.
Old Wooten. Got kids on the bike. And our deputy sheriff.
This is Joe White.
Chief deputy.
Merry right. Christmas. You hear that?
Mm-hmm.
They're revving it up.
Yeah. Moving down the highway.
71.
Looking for adventure. All right.
This is the Joker's Motorcycle Club wishing everyone a Merry Christmas.
All right, slow down. We're trying to get a visual.
Y'all slow them down.
There we go.
Your young man is just running behind y'all.
Yeah.
These are just bikers and riders.
All right.
They're revving it up. Merry Christmas to all our motorcycle riders
and
the various clubs around in Coffee County. We invite all of you to our South Georgia Barbecue and Outdoor Festival the second weekend of September. Y'all bring those motorcycles and come on and join.
Okay.
There that is.
All right. All right, that's a tricked out Harley Chevrolet.
Woo! These are our Douglas Police heat cars.
You have something to say about them?
Yeah, these are our heat cars in a collaboration with the county and the city of Douglas.
They actually help us
prevent a lot of situations as far as traffic fatalities throughout Coffee County. So we really appreciate them being on the road.
So our Douglas Fire Department Color Guard, we can definitely count on them for a lot of our ceremonial events throughout the city of Douglas, presenting the flags. And coming up is our parade marshal for this year. I need everybody on the streets to give this lady a hand.
Give her a hand.
Joanne Lewis.
Amen. All right.
For more than 30 years, she has provided economic development experiences with our local and state governments. On a local level, she has served as Main Street Director of Tourism and Community Services Director for the City of Douglas. She later served as Statewide Tourism Product Development Manager for Georgia Department of Economic Development, the Development Authority as Executive Director, and Lewis recently announced that she will retire in February 2016. She has found success in bringing new investment and jobs to rural Georgia. Her success has been driven by the availability of infrastructure and facility inventory as the foundation of recruitment efforts. She received the Georgia's Al Burris Lifetime Achievement Award for the State of Georgia, Regional Partnership Award from East Central Technical College, and was recognized in 2007 as the national recipient for the Economic Development Leadership Award by the National Rural Economic Development Association. Her time and talent amplified success at work and through volunteerism in the local community, region, and the state of Georgia. Lewis's personal passion has been rehabilitation for those who suffer from addiction issues. She invested her own personal time and money to open Still Waters, a Christian women's outreach center located on Highway 221 in Douglas, Georgia, of last year. Again, we applaud this jewel, this community cheerleader that
right.
we have.
Great job, Joanne.
I love you, Joanne.
Love you,
and
Joanne.
Andrea Taylor right
Thank
here.
You for
yes.
all you do. All right.
And Merry Christmas to all of you.
And Lee Taylor right there with the Santa Claus hat on as well, too.
All right. Coming up, we got the mayor, James Dennis, I believe. Does he have his wife in the car with him, Miss Judy?
We thank Merry him Christmas. For serving a term. Merry Christmas, yeah. Mayor Dennis.
Thank you for 4 years of service. We appreciate it. Let's see here.
In the very front.
We have Commissioner Marty Swain.
Commissioner Swain has served 8 years. Thank you for your service
right. hey,
to this
sir.
Community. Merry
yes,
Christmas.
Sir. I think he got a Mustang like that with a 5.0, yeah.
This is Commissioner Dennis Josie. He has served 12 years. Thank you, Commissioner Josie, for your service to this community.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
All right.
And coming up is Commissioner Ronnie Anderson, who has served for a whopping 27 and a half years.
Wow, let's give him a round of applause.
He has
Amen.
Served this community.
And his lovely wife in the car with him.
Thank you, Commissioner Anderson. Merry Christmas.
He's a cut up, I tell you.
Coming up, another city commissioner, Mr. Bob Moore, who has served this community also an amazing 22 and a half years.
All right.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Hello, Miss Barbara.
And his lovely wife, Barbara, in the back.
Yep.
All right.
Thank you for your time.
And this is County Commissioner Oscar Paul.
Yes, and his family.
Serving his first term and
his
wife,
darling. Walk in the back. Right. Merry Christmas,
yes, Merry
Commissioner.
Christmas. All right.
Thank you for serving right. this community.
City of Broxton, Councilman Ronnie Graham.
And Merry Christmas to the Graham family.
He cut up.
I see you back
and
there.
And Ronnie
Merry
probably
Christmas.
Knows 50 Cent, Terrell. What's up, Ronnie?
Merry
Love
Christmas,
you, man. Buddy.
Appreciate you. Ronnie's real active in our Parks and Recreation. We appreciate him much.
The Mayor of Broxton, Ms. Darquita Riley. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
To
she
you
does
and your
a great
family.
Job.
I need to talk to you about that bracelet, ma'am.
Oh,
Merry
Lord.
Christmas.
She going to take your
just
bracelet
keep,
off.
Keep waving.
Look at here. Favor ain't fair. It ain't fair. It's just what it
it's
is.
It's fair.
It's fair.
It's fair.
All right. Ms. Sylvia Stone, our probate judge. And thank you for everything that you do, for getting a lot of people married in this community.
And this makes her 12th consecutive year riding in the parade. We thank
Merry
you
Christmas.
For serving this
Merry
community.
Christmas.
The probate judge does more than married people now. I just want y'all to know that now, okay? All right. Chief Magistrate Judge, Ms. Anna Marie Fussell. She wishes everybody a Merry Christmas.
Magistrate Anna Marie Fussell, friends, family, and staff wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Judge Fussell would like to remind everyone that maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from the store. Maybe Christmas perhaps means a little bit more.
And look at the beautiful float and balloons. I believe the balloons came from right across the road from Wendy's. Very beautiful. Merry Christmas.
A lot of passengers too. And the Grinch.
They don't have a thing.
Who is that?
We have our mayor-elect, Tony Paul. I believe that's, is his wife in the car with him? Chevelle, all right, yeah, all right.
Are you hiding, Miss Chevelle?
Yeah, don't hide, don't hide. We see you.
Merry Christmas to the Paul family.
Merry Christmas.
All right.
This is Commissioner-elect. Mr. Johnny Lee Roper.
All right.
Mr. Johnny Lee.
In the parade.
Lee.
Watch out now. Watch out now. All
Watch
right.
out, Mr. Johnny Lee.
I like Mr. Roper saying, if you see a turd on a fence post, somebody had to put him in there.
That's right.
That's right. All right. Now.
This is Commissioner-elect Contewan Durham. He is for Ward 2, and his slogan is, A New Voice for a Better Choice.
Now,
and he wishes everyone a Merry Christmas.
Now, I don't know if he wants everybody to know his nickname.
He needs to be on The Voice. Isn't that right, Tay-Tay? He needs to be on The Voice, my friend.
Merry Christmas.
Absolutely. Great job he does.
Once again, Danny's All-Star Marching Band is back in the parade, and we will give them an opportunity to do their showcasing of what they can do. So listen up and watch Danny's All-Star Marching Band.